So we find that a given function ft, we transform its cosine, we find out its cosine transform fc omega, and we find its sine transform fs omega. Then for a given function ft, there are two functions, either f of minus t and minus of f of minus t. That is, a given function, its immediate mirror image and inverted mirror image. So what do we do is that we have got ft, we have got its mirror image f of minus t and inverted mirror image of minus of f of minus t. Suppose if this ft is having a cosine transform fc omega and is having a sine transform fs omega, then if I know both, if I know only fc omega, then I know that its image f of minus t also gives me this. If I only know sine transform, then inverted image gives me this. So if I know only cosine transform, then cosine transform can be either because of this or because of this. So I get two answers. If I know sine transform, sine transform either because of this or because of this, I get two answers. But if I know both, a function whose cosine transform is this, these two answers. A function whose sine transform also this, then these two answers. And only this ft satisfies both of these. So, if what I say that a combination ft gives rise to fc omega and fs omega, so the pair of fc omega and fs omega, this is now 1-to-1. मराठीत सांगतो म्हणजे एफ टी पासून एफ सी ओमेगा दिलेला एफ सी ओमेगा आणि दिलेला एफ एस ओमेगा हे एकाच एफ टी पासून येतात. एफ सी ओमेगा दोन फंक्शन पासून येऊ शकतो, एफ एस ओमेगा दोन फंक्शन पासून येऊ शकतो, परंतु एफ सी ओमेगा आणि एफ एस ओमेगा माहीत असतील तर ते एकाच फंक्शन पासून आले असतात. अँड दॅट इज दिस. सो fc omega and fs omega as a combination is invertible transform, and when I have a combination and when I express a combination in a given sequence, what I do is ft gives rise to a pair of two functions, and I know that pair I express as complex number fc omega plus j into fs omega. So that is ft. So a pair fc omega, how I get it? Minus infinity to infinity ft cos omega t dt plus it's a pair, it's these two are different entities, just for the sake of expressing them in one, I say j into minus infinity to infinity ft sine omega t dt. Then since limits are same, I can combine, and when I combine, it is minus infinity to infinity ft into bracket cos omega t plus j sin omega t dt, that is minus infinity to infinity ft e raised to minus j minus j omega t dt. Why this minus? Because just for the sake, it is just like a left hand drive and right hand drive. It is like left hand drive and right hand drive. Just for the sake of transformation, just for the sake, I again repeat, transform if was a j omega t, then inverse would have been minus. So just for the sake of transform, it was decided to use minus. So we use minus here, we use minus. So, and this is called as Fourier transform. This is the definition of a Fourier transform, a known Fourier transform. F t e raised to minus j, given function multiplied by e raised to minus j omega t dt. Let it be very clear that introduction of complex number in integration is something which at the beginning is beyond the scope of an individual. Therefore, this is just the way. This I will say, I means, so the, if one has to go by classical method, this is Fourier transform. You can compute very easily. This is a different Fourier transform, and there is a different inverse also, which you can go through. F t is equal to 1 upon 2 pi minus infinity to infinity. F of omega e raised to j omega t dt, this is inverse. How this these two are matching with each other, we will elaborate it later. One thing is very clear, that f t is a continuous function, f omega is also a continuous function. F omega is a ordered pair. One means what is Fourier transform? Cosine transform and sine transform computed separately and taken expressed together as an ordered pair in the complex number form. So Fourier transform is f omega f t e raised to minus j omega t dt. Input is continuous, output is continuous. Same like Laplace transform. Laplace transform also, which we are discussing last semester, and we will Professor Joshi has taken special lectures also. So Laplace transform also, input is continuous and output is continuous. These both of these are continuous transform. So this is Fourier transform. I again repeat that this is difficult to understand, therefore never use this. Ft cos omega t dt integrated from minus infinity to infinity, you get sine cosine transform. Ft sine omega t dt integrated from minus infinity to infinity, you get sine transform. And ordered pair fc omega t, just it is expressed at just one way, minus j fs omega, fc omega minus j fs omega. Cosine transform and sine transform, which we just use minus. So that is what we get as a Fourier transform. I think for today it is enough. Thank you.